It's another word for Cerberus, which in the magical realms, Cerberus is a Kerberos, a guardian of the underworld. And like Cerberus, all of these Kerberos, they're charged with maintaining the laws of the underworld.
Okay.
So they're the police down here.
Okay. That guy wasn't a three-headed dog.
It's so Cerberus is a canine unit.
Yep.
Just in case the people trying to get into hell are sneaking in drugs.
Yep.
It's the underworld.
Or souls.
Oh, right. The
there's a big difference.
Yeah, it's not.
Hell is deeper.
Yep. We were going to go through hell and make a deal with a demon to get out, but instead we cooked dinner for some elves.
Yep.
Do you two know if they are undead entities?
Do I?
They are of the underworld. Their precise nature is not well known, so you do not really know much more than that, unfortunately.
I don't know. They live here. They to quote the text, they are of the underworld, and I put up quote marks.
Doing like the air quotes with your fingers.
Yep, that's what I did, yeah.
Nice. Okay. Well, as we walk, I'll chat with them.
And Herb, you feel like you've read books about the underworld and the denizens of it before being a student of the Death Arcana, but you can't remember the details about that. There is not very much information about them that is known, but yeah, you can't remember the details right now. Maybe if you had your books or whatnot, you could
I'm wondering,
refresh yourself. But
for transform life, you know how you can like change your body?
Yep.
Is there a way to like boost your memory from that?
Yeah, that's called the mind arcana.
Okay. So
yeah, that's pretty firmly in the mind arcana territory.
I can't like make my brain 10% bigger and then
no
remember it suddenly. Okay.
No, because magic is it is the realm of symbology, not the realm of science.
Right?
Okay. Do my arm racks impede my spell casting at all?
Nope.
Okay.
Unless you're trying to like touch someone as part of the spell.
Yeah, or like draw runes on something.
Yeah, obviously. Yeah, obviously that would be very hard.
Has it been an hour? Like, kind of since Herb went missing?
Maybe like
it's been about a scene anyway.
Yeah, did you have an active spell or something?
Yeah, and I had six active spells up when I cast that Strings of Fate.
Oh, okay.
So that's a bunch of paradox, I think.
Well, yeah, it's a lot more reaches.
Yeah.
What spells do you have?
So I have Veil for a year, Miracle for a month, Momentary Flux on Herb for a day to find her thing. Strings for a day on Herb. Momentary Flux set as a day. What the fuck is that for? Oh, on me. The fuck is moment? Oh yeah, to know if
Check will be good or
yes,
bad.
Yes, if we go down this alleyway, are we gonna get is it bad or good?
Yeah, you had prophecy and acceleration.
Yeah. So the prophecy.
Well, yeah,
and acceleration.
I think they are probably
okay. Bling, blow.
Say that it has been a scene. So.
Mm-hmm. And we're not acting particularly accelerated.
Yeah, I think you did that for the search, and then after that point.
Okay, Because, yeah, I mean, I would have just burnt up the prophecy spell trying to find herb.
Yeah, so you're at your max active spell.
Yeah. So you found... Is your thing done, then, down here, Herb? Because,
Yeah, so I found my grandson and ran into the Kerberos.
Oh, yeah.
I was able to move my Jonathan's spirit to an anchor temporarily. And the Kerberos wanted him back, essentially, and I refused, but told him that we could discuss it later and we'll finish his tasks in the meantime. And as I took something from him, he took something from me, and I'll kind of like show my hand a little bit.
Oh.
Something that can be fixed later, but if I fix it now, I'm afraid it might upset him, so I'm just going to leave it.
Sam is going to try not to think about another hand thing that has happened to him in the past. and fail at it, because honestly, black was coming from her hands, right?
Yeah.
So,
God, that was crazy.
I've asked you two to help me. Will you help me later on if whatever comes from that decision, and I'll help you get home?
Well, we'll see.
All right.
And my suspicion is you're about to anger something of unknown power.
Like, we haven't done that.
I mean, yeah.
Honestly, I don't care. Yeah, I'll help you. I'll punch a guard dog in the face. I don't care. When I say punch, I mean smash him with some magic.
Well, it might not come to that. Also, he might be listening.
Hey! We're gonna do your shit, and I know that you are bound by your deals, so just lay off, you fucker.
Why don't you guys give me wits and composure roll?
Sam is going to try and not... Oh, God. Suddenly I'm associated with these people.
Wits and composure... Yep. I can never remember my composure. I think it's 3. My wits is 3. Oh, no, my wits is 4. My composure is 3. Hooray! Even more than I thought.
I got 1.
It was 2, 1, and what'd Gray get?
3 nines. That's kind of cool. And they're all in a little pile. Yeah, 3 successes.
Okay, so you turn around, kind of like look. Around the hallway that you're in, and as you kind of like shout out Gray, you spot a little slithering shadow in the corner of like slide out from one of the little like cracks in the wall. Mm-hmm. And when you look towards it, it like tucks back in.
Oh, hey,
you are being watched.
Well, I don't know if any of you saw that with your old eyes, but...
Hey. Yeah.
What?
There's... Well, did you see it, Samuel?
Yeah. Also, thinking about it, there probably would have been bonuses for Eagle Eyes and whatnot, but next time. We'll get it. We'll remember next time.
Yeah. But yeah... We are definitely... There's something slithering about keeping tabs on us down here.
Yeah, what does Eagle Eyes even do for a person?
It makes you able to spot stuff
see,
at
like,
tiny...
Far, like, distances, right?
Yep, tiny things at huge distance.
Yeah.
don't know if it's half a mile or a full mile. It's a lot. It's a lot of. It's thousands of feet.
You can. I don't remember what reaches I did with this. Oh man, I did.
Just recast it.
I mean, like, I know I did the atmospheric conditions thing, but I don't know if I did the can discern tiny things for 1 mile away per dot of forces.
Anyway. Yeah, you did do that.
Okay.
I mean, it's mostly distance.
Yep, stuff, it's distance seeing.
So it probably wouldn't help you that much in this situation.
That's true.
Binoculars ain't gonna help you no. spot something sneaking up behind you.
We have to turn them around.
Yeah.
Something's coming from miles. Oh wait, shit.
Yeah. So yeah, you know that.
Anyways,
you spot a little slithering.
Also, Herb. Or Herb. God damn it. I would be willing to just try some stuff later on anyway to help you with your situation, and I don't know, I always like fucking with fate. It seems it's like a hobby of mine, so
Sam will just
very interesting people you are. I'm happy to have met you.
Well, while you guys are talking, I assume that you're walking. Following the trail back towards the yes. hospital area.
Okay. Yeah.
Sounds good.
Amadine has been around my shenanigans, has been involved in my shenanigans for far too long, I believe. I say yes to too many things too quickly.
And yet, I believe I'd be dead if you weren't here.
And I think that's half the problem. Is I can get out of any situation I get into, so I don't care. Or at least I don't care much.
I have indeed.
Yep. Yeah.
However,
bravado from someone who hasn't failed yet at getting out of situations.
Yep, exactly.
And there will be a day when you do, and that will be your final day.
That will be the like. Well, okay, that good. Good,
you
got me.
The hustle to your dying breath.
Yep.
Well, yeah. Looks I like... remember that one time when you escaped from the throne people.
Yep.
That was pretty close to
that. Yeah. That was.
Oh my goodness.
Were you there still for that? Were you still Cash? What? I got.
I'm not sure.
I got led into a. I like willingly went with some people, into like a.
Basically, interrogation room.
Yeah, interrogation room where they had magical contingencies.
Except through a portal.
Yeah, and I was like, whatever, fuck them. I got. I'm time mage. And they had contingencies and stuff. Like I had to roll pretty high to get out of there, and I made it. And it was if I didn't make it, that'd have been it.
Like you that. Captured like, by yeah. the iron.
The campaign would have changed, like focus, because we were doing something.
Yeah. And that's why you're the. Self-proclaimed, what'd you say, best goddamn time mage in existence or
yep,
something like
exactly,
that?
Yep, exactly, yeah. I haven't lost yet to time battles. And then I've recently beaten elves at, like, who are made of fate magic. Like, I've beat them, too, so that's why I'm saying fate mage also. The only problem is the fate entity has still got my number.
Mm-hmm.
She can just at any time. Oh yeah, I don't know how closely tied you want to be to me, because at any given point in my existence, at least for two more times, fate can just decide to fuck me. Like, And it's going to be at very, very high stakes situations.
Hmm.
Because I've poked the bear too many times.
Well, I guess we'll see what happens.
Mm-hmm. We will. it's going to be a fun ride. we'll see.
So you guys retrace your steps back to the Terminus Wing kind of hospital asylum area. And I believe Amadine had located the shade which you're supposed to deliver this memento, which is like a picture of a young child.
Yep.
Kind of like slightly worn, a little burnt on the edges. Supposed to deliver that to them. So you make your way down a dark hospital hallway, kind of flickering with like the just bulbs hanging from the ceiling, and to
swinging and creaking. And...
Yep. To a hospital room that is old, pale gray black. You hear a faint like deep, deep, deep.
Smells of plastic and death.
Yep. And kind of looking into the room, you see there is an old woman who is just like incredibly like frail and anemic looking, a shade who probably wasted away at an old age from various medical problems, and lays still in her hospital bed, unable to forget that death. You guys are
She's on the hospital bed, unable to what?
Forget her death.
And that's causing her, like, pain or something?
Well, most of these ghosts are like that. They're fragments of loss.
Okay.
And grief.
She matched the drawing that Gray did.
Yeah, Gray took. You compared it before. You kind of like hold up the picture again and confirm. Okay, yep, yeah, this appears to be the right shade.
All right. So who's got the doodad? Gray, right?
Photograph.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
For the what? Yeah. Oh, I just approach and see if she makes, you know, eye contact or any of that. And
you hear through the beeping, you hear her kind of like move her head slightly and says,
who's there? Is there someone here to see me?"
I kind of put the. So now I can't. I don't remember if we discussed the rules, if they apply when we are helping people. Like, cause this is
none shall speak to a shit.
Yep. All right. I ain't saying shit. Yep. I ain't saying shit. I just put the picture in her hand. Like, trying, you know.
And see her cold, like black eye, cold dead eyes, kind of shift and look at the picture that rests in her hand, and you see it kind of like move in a wind that doesn't exist as she holds it, and she says,
my son, are you here? Have you come to visit?
We'll take some steps back.
Come here, my son, please. Where is my son? Where is my son? Where are you?
And then she begins to like just give out this like horrible, like keening, wailing sound, which is borders on inhuman. It just sends like a shiver down your spine.
Oh dear.
You do not seem to have helped her by giving this to her.
Damn.
Helping her was not part of what we were supposed to do, so...
Apparently not.
Yep.
Did we harm her?
Difficult to say.
Well,
at least she's not thinking about her death anymore.
Nope. Okay, hold on. What's the goddamn spell called? It's even one of my things. Shifting Sands. Okay. I go back.
Okay.
Hi-ya! Jesus Christ. I succeeded.
Right. So, who's got the doodad?
I do. All right, sidebar. If I give this to her, she's gonna fucking freak out.
Are you talking to us?
Yeah, like I went back in time. I cast it. I got it. I got this picture.
Like freak out, like fight us or what?
No, she's just gonna like start talking about her son and like, where is he and like is he here or like is he come to visit? And then she's gonna let out like a fucking horrible death wail, you know, like ghostly wail, and it's bad. We're not doing any favors by giving her this picture, so.
Maybe give her a hug as well.
Okay, but.
Is it shadowy in here?
Yeah, pretty shadowy.
I could try to make the shadows look like her son. For a time.
Okay.
If you think that would help.
I have no idea what's gonna help.
What is she wanting when she's wailing and screaming?
To know where her son is? Like, or where is my son is the general consensus.
Well... Yeah, I could turn the shadows to look like her son, but it would only be temporary, so probably.
Maybe it'd be long enough to get closure, like some, you know, the whole, oh, you've come to visit, yay. Now, then, I don't know, then it's enough. I don't know.
Then make the shadows, like, wave when they have to leave.
Yeah.
Okay, we could try it.
Alright.
You want to?
What were you talking about, doodad? I thought that was the picture.
Yeah, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, because that's what we're doing. I'm just delivering this picture to her.
We could have the shadows.
And just kind of like raises an eyebrow and gestures, be like, well.
Okay, I'll try to cast this.
Yeah, all right. Well, we'll try this again. But if this doesn't work, then I don't know what the hell to do. And we're just going to have a semi... bad act on our conscience for a little while. Where we made this ghost shade person feel even worse for being dead.
Man, she must have been doing something horrible if you decided to time travel for it.
I don't know. It's honestly not that hard anymore.
Oh, well, alright.
I've time traveled in the morning when I stubbed my toe.
Time travels to alleviate an awkward social situation.
Yep.
Huh.
Well, I can't talk to her. I can't be like, hey, lady, calm down. Then I don't know. Then I die. I don't know what happens. I can't remember.
So,
pay the consequence.
Yeah, see, we don't know. So I figured it's just easier to just try again.
Okay, then.
I'm the king of do-overs.
Cast shadow sculpting.
Okay.
With the reach so that I can change the shape of the shadows and animate them so they seem, you know, it seems like her son, and try to make it look like the picture.
Okay, sure.
And then I'm going to... I'll try making it indefinite.
Oh.
For indefinite. Indefinite, you have to spend experience.
You have to spend a reach and a point of...
Some reach and mana. Does that remove it from my...
No.
It'll still be on your spells cast unless you spend a point of experience.
Well, yeah, so how it works is you still have to concentrate it on it.
And it'll deteriorate.
If you want to stop having it as one of your active spells, you can relinquish it. You can do so safely or unguarded. If you do it unguarded, it will slowly deteriorate and cause like abyssal like leaking out of the spell over time until it just kind of like rips itself apart.
Oh my goodness. Yeah. Celeste, you probably do that all the time.
Yeah. Yeah, definitely.
But
if you want to relinquish it safely, which is the only way to really get like permanent magic that isn't has the lasting thing on, then you have to spend a dot of willpower, which equates to a point of experience.
To get it back,
yes.
Right.
Yeah, that's
you permanently reduce your willpower by one, which you can regain with a point of experience.
Okay.
Which I've done a couple of times. For traffic.
Yep.
And then once for something else, I can't remember.
Yeah. Well, that's... I decide that if it succeeds, right?
Yeah. Well, I mean, yeah, first you have to cast it indefinitely. And then you can relinquish it at any point after that.
Oh, okay.
Yep.
So, yeah, I'll do that. And it's going to cost... It's not a praxis, so it costs a mana and then another mana for it being indefinite.
Yep, and then it's the penalty for indefinite spell.
Honestly, man, a year would be enough, but...
It said 4. Minus 4 dice?
Yeah, that sounds right, because you got 4 dots. It's minus... So I know it's minus 10 without from like base level to max. You're 3 levels up. So you're casting at a 4 duration. Yeah, minus 4.
Okay. And then since I have an extra reach, can I try to make it even more lifelike?
In what way?
So like, it doesn't talk, but it'll like move around and act like a person would if they were visiting a loved one.
This is shape shadow. Shadow sculpt. Is it a 3 dot?
It's a 1 dot.
Oh, okay.
Well, just casting a 1 dot at high end.
Yep.
That's always fun. Post-cog, the last decade.
I'll say that you could spend the extra reach to have it kind of like flicker in the general approximation of a person. It like it's not going to be very accurate, but...
Well, I'm sure this lady's fucking brain isn't very accurate.
It's about anymore. As convincing as like an animatronic thing that has like one movement it does.
Yep.
Yeah.
Is there a spell that's higher dot than this that...
Because
I'm not seeing anything.
I mean, there's shadow crafting, but that's for, like, objects.
I mean, I could probably do it.
Mm-hmm. So Sam's over there. Like, I guess I could do it. This is ridiculous.
I think that's probably enough for your...
Okay, I'll do this.
Man, that's nuts. Good.
Choose the dice that I'm guessing aren't going to betray me this time.
I got to send you this, this link to dice training. by
Z Bashu?
Yep, him.
Yeah.
That's a good one.
One success.
What was that? One success?
Yep.
Okay. So as you cast the spell, the shadows kind of twist and bend inwards towards the bed, and you see the kind of flickering image of a small boy in the shadow, which, you know, is just straight up nightmare fuel to any normal person. This is like pure horror movie shit.
Oh, well, that's horrifying.
But yeah, it's like a young, like the silhouette of a young boy who's kind of like jumping, like moving slightly around the foot of the bed.
All right, I'm going to give her I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to approach before she sees that, because I want her to, like, see the picture first.
Yeah, and, like, correlate.
Yes.
Yep, okay.
That would be scared.
Why don't you give me Gray, why don't you give me a manipulation and subterfuge roll?
All right. I actually have, I think, both of them.
No. Criminal?
Yeah. Let's see. Okay. Manipulate. Why is that up on top? Oh, it is. It's okay. So three there. Subterfuge.
Do not have any dots.
I do not. Wish I could cast, because then I could. I can like give myself dots and things.
That's useful.
Yeah. manipulation is 3, and that is a minus what, 1 if I don't have it?
Yep.
Okay. Hey, I got an 8.
Nice.
Fucking A.
So you place the, how do you like kind of hold out the picture and sort of step behind the shadows as you, the animate shadows as you do so. And, the old woman kind of takes this and says, my son, have you come to visit me? Where? My son, where are you?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, like...
You see the eyes kind of slowly travel to the end of the bed and says,
my son, come closer. Talk to me, my son. Come here.
This is gonna go about the same.
She continues to like to do that. It seems to. It just kind of like goes on and on like that.
They're in a loop. Yes.
Yeah. Like. Yeah. They kind of just. Stuck in a loop where she's like almost talking to her son, but not. She's just being like led on continuously, pretty much, and doesn't really seem to have the faculties to realize that.
Okay.
So yeah, it just, I mean, she doesn't start like wailing or anything.
All right, good.
It just like continues that way.
That's better.
Yeah, she's being permanently teased instead of permanently tormented.
Yeah,
exactly.
So
at the end, that teased means that there's hope. Tormented, right, exactly. It's over.
Exactly. A shadow of hope, one yes. might say.
Exactly. Ooh. Nice. A sliver of a shadow of hope. Now, Amadine, what was the fucking wording of the tasks?
I think he just gave us the first.
I think we were two. Go get a picture.
The second task has been complete.
Hey.
As you... He's standing right behind you.
Oh!
He's like arms crossed, kind of like a little further down the hallway.
Oh. Okay.
You will perform a... third and final task.
Okay. Has he told us what that is going to be yet?
Because if he has, I've totally forgotten.
He has not.
Oh, okay, okay.
After which, the one who has...
After which, the witch shall talk to me. No.
After which, the one who has stolen from this domain will face judgment. You must find there is within this realm a trespasser who refuses to follow my laws, the laws. You will rid this realm of them.
All right, I cast a time skip on Herb.
What?
Just get her the hell out of here. She's a trespasser that's not following his laws. Like, just put her out of existence for, like, a minute.
Are you actually going to do that?
God, I want to. I really do. Because I think that would be, like, contractually to the words that he just said. Like, boom. She's a trespasser. Not supposed to be here. And she's not following his laws. And by those words is get him out. And making her not exist in time for a minute would technically cover all those bases.
But I did follow his, like, I haven't spoken to any shades or harmed any shades.
All right, yeah. Plus, I don't really know about the deal that's going on either that you guys did. So, yep, no, no.
So from, like, the shadows behind his back, he pulls out this, like, this goblet kind of thing, which seems to just be, like, full of, like, black liquid, and he pours it onto the ground and says, the waters will run to the lowest point where this trespasser is. Seek them out and be rid of them.
Seek them out and what?
Be rid of them.
Oh.
And you see the liquid kind of trickling down the hallway like it's running down a slope. It doesn't exist as far as you can see.
Okay.
Yeah.
Now,
the lowest point is like the person who has his least respect.
Yeah. It's a right... metaphorical lowest point.
Can I, when? So when he's. When did he say that, and when did he start pouring? Like, is it all simultaneously?
Yeah, he poured it as he was saying.
Okay, so pretty much right at the end of his sentence, I'm going to go back in time again to the beginning of his sentence, when he, like, basically started pouring. I'm testing to see if there's clash of wills here, or if I have free reign of time.
Okay, so you're gonna go back 5 seconds or
yep,
something?
Yep. Because that, like, that's a big thing. Like, okay, the water's pouring, he's mid, like, yeah, if he doesn't, if there's no clash here, he doesn't care.
Okay. Go ahead and roll that. Roll the spell.
Yep.
You succeed?
3, and I think that's a... Oh, no, it's not a praxis. It's a, what's it called? It's
a rote.
Rote, so... Yep, nothing okay. happens.
You go back in time 5 seconds.
Yep. And so no clash?
It works. No clash.
Okay.
No resistance to your spell.
So does he just, like, without skipping a beat, he just rewinds and keeps speaking, like you
he
know...
He does the exact same thing he did, because yep. nothing changed.
Okay. Yeah, great. He's just like, wow. Yeah, he's...
Except this time he perhaps raises an eyebrow at you giggling.
He doesn't seem to have eyebrows.
Oh, so. Well. Yeah, that's right. He doesn't. He has like, he's got like a whole thing going on like, in for his head.
Shadowy eye stalk things.
Mm-hmm. All right.
All right. So yeah, then he explains the lowest point, and okay, that is quite the clairvoyant water stream. It's an odd way of doing it.
If I
ask, the third task has been set. Perform it or be in violation of the laws of this domain.
May I trouble you for a question about our target?
Just kind of like doesn't say anything, just like turns and looks at you expectantly.
Is the one we seek a living person or?
Yes.
Okay. Thank you.
Kind of like steps to the side of the hallway. Waits for you to proceed.
Okay.
I'm like all smiles now. Like I don't even. I'm like bad at. I'm like bad at hiding it. Like I don't care. Your rules mean nothing to me now. Is how I'm in my own head. Ooh, violation of the rules.
Sam will follow the water.
All right.
Just keep an eye on that.
Yep. So it kind of trickles out. As you follow it, you kind of leave the sort of hospital area and. You see there are like little rivulets trickling down from the walls and like joining this flow. So it's kind of like a weird stream that's just kind of created around you.
My feet getting wet?
It's not enough for that. Yeah, I mean, as long as you're careful with where you put your feet, you're okay.
Okay. I mean, I guess it doesn't really matter. It's just, yeah.
Also, you're a forces mage, so if your feet, you don't want your feet to get wet, then they aren't wet.
Right. Yep. The question behind the question was, should I cast a fly spell? But we'll see.
Yeah. No, it's a very small one.
All right.
So you move through the tunnels further on,
glancing back every once in a while to make sure that she's still with us.
Yeah.
Yeah, right. Everybody sticking together?
Yeah.
Yep.
Also, I mention... No, I don't mention. So I tell the DM that I have dropped... Way back when I asked if Herb's task was complete. Like, if, you know, I took it... I dropped that one, the Strings of Fate, that made it better. Mm-hmm. Made her task easier. So,
you lost concentration on,
yep,
or
yep.
You let go of that spell. Yep. Okay,
so I wouldn't sounds be good. At max spells all the time.
Yep,
because otherwise,
yep,
those two,
good idea.
Yeah, those two time spells would have been paradoxy.
Yep. Okay, so yeah, you follow this trickle of liquid down. You actually do start heading like downhill slightly. It seems. The hallways begin to sort of like tilt, and you find yourself heading into more like natural caverns or like a mine shaft kind of thing. So like roughly hewn stone walls, and you actually pass by like a little rail track. So like you hit the rail track and the water kind of like runs into the rails and runs down And you keep following it for quite some time, probably at least another half hour to an hour.
Yeah. Is there like the same density of shades down here, or?
It seems to be slightly more infrequent. There was more in like the hospital area. It seemed more concentrated. Down here, you occasionally run into people. Like a couple. Yeah.
Yeah. More people have died in hospitals than in mines.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So you continue to follow it for about an hour. And I'm going to go to the bathroom real quick. Mm-hmm. So we'll get to what you find after that.
Mm-hmm.
Good. Hey, have either of you, unless you guys are going to go take a break quick too.
No, I'm good.
I'm looking at a spell called Knit, and it's like, it heals.
Right? Oh, yeah.
And it's a potency spell. If I made that a permanent spell, would I be like Wolverine? Always continuously healing?
We've been playing it as spells that seem to have like an instantaneous duration, aren't particularly affected by the duration parameter.
Okay.
So like, when I like do a telekinetic strike to damage somebody, duration kind of doesn't make sense for that.
That makes sense.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, I don't know if that's in the rules anywhere, but
that'd be pretty cool if I could cast permanent spells to make us constantly healing, though.
Yeah.
As soon as you take damage, it just heals.
Yeah. Well, Mike's has the ability to cast a spell, but like, I forget what it's called, like Hung Spell or something, which lets you load in some other spell until some trigger happens, because he's a time mage and can delay things like that.
Nice.
I have returned.
Hello.
Everybody still here?
Don't know if Mike is.
Seems as though he may not be.
So, Ben, we were kind of talking about potency spells that happen like instantaneously. For example, Knit, the healing spell.
Mm-hmm.
There's not a way to make that indefinite if you put the duration. So, like, as soon as you, like, your body's always healing?
No, because, that would be, like, insanely overpowered.
All right, fair enough. Like, Wolverine.
Just, like, give yourself super amazing regeneration.
Yeah. That'd be useful.
That would be too good.
But you can make, so transform life is a potency spell, and that has a reach saying that you can, like, if you make it indefinite.
Yeah.
So that one, it would work because it's in the reach.
Yeah, I mean, like, there is a lot of open to interpretation stuff. Okay. Yeah, they leave some of it open. I think in general, the instantaneous effect things, like Knit is different from Transform Life, because Transform Life is, like, it's intended to not happen instant. It's not, like, a single effect that happens when it's done, right?
Yeah.
You give yourself claws or whatever for whatever duration.
Okay.
Well, I guess while we're waiting for Micah, just
Sorry, I was muted.
Oh, you're here.
Yeah, I was here, and I was like, "Hey, I'm back." And then you were talking, so I was like, "Oh, okay." I'm, you know.
Yeah. So make sure to look through the attainments, Austin, which is at the end of the magic section. Because you get some special stuff for being having like skill in certain arcana, for instance, life arcana. You can heal your wounds more efficiently with mana, like self heal, and with the four dots you can also it's pretty good. You have body autonomy, so you gain a automatic, or you may spend a point of mana to gain an automatic clash of wills against any effect that would alter your physical body, put a personal tilt on you, such as the arm rack that you suffered, suffer damage from a supernatural power that would injure you.
And so can I do that at any time?
At any time that it happens, you can do it as a free action. Just like enter a clash of wills against whatever's going on and be like, no, I am not going to suffer this.
Okay. So I can't do it now for what?
Oh, it's reactionary to the effect.
Okay. Cool.
Okay, so you guys continue on through the into like this sort of mine area.
Mm-hmm.
As you pass through, you see ahead of you kind of down a steeper slope out into a larger kind of cavern type area. There is this pale sort of like whitish light, whitish green light, looks like a lantern or some kind or something. And are you just continuing to walk forward?
Sorry, I was reading Forrest's attainments. I guess we haven't seen like monsters or anything yet.
Yeah, nothing really aggressive. This seems to be a fairly quiet place. So you just kind of continue to walk forward. As you draw closer, you see a humanoid figure, kind of has like a backpack on and has this lantern kind of hanging off the side of the backpack, flickering with this like white green flame.
Hmm.
And the there is a larger figure who kind of turns towards you, or it is like kind of staring in the direction of the tunnel. As you approach, you see they have these like glowing sort of reddish eyes, just like a really big dude basically. And they kind of the big guy sort of like moves forward to intersect themselves between you and the lantern bearing figure who kind of like stands up and turns around to look in your direction.
Right.
And you so see go ahead.
So this big guy looks like a human, or is this like some sort of bear?
He's a human. He looks like a human, but as you get closer with your night vision, you can tell his body is like that of a corpse.
Oh.
It's like a giant sort of zombie man.
Kind of
thing. And he seems more like all the specters here, they are physically solid.
Right.
This person seems more solid than them. Hard to place why, but like just the way that he interacts with the world seems to be more grounded in reality, I guess you could say.
Right. Like if we were being particularly observant, like he moves the gravel around, but maybe the shades don't.
Yes. Yeah, exactly. That sort of thing.
Okay.
So the person with the lantern stands up and you see is kind of like a younger man, late 20s, kind of like a darker sort of tanned skin, with long black hair, pulled back away from his face. He has a bunch of like backpacking and like mountaineering kind of gear, just like explorer type things, something you'd use in like spelunking or whatnot.
Right.
Lots of pockets. And
it occurs to me that I should cast a spell. I'm just going to do wards and signs. So I'm going to click some buttons here.
Okay. You see, as he stands up and turns to you, he's holding like a human skull in one of his hands.
Huh.
And he kind of like, as you approach, he sort of holds up a hand and says, "Who are you? I don't want to fight you, but I will if I have to."
Right, let me finish clicking these buttons here. It seems I made this a praxis, didn't I? I did.
Here you go.
Are you casting wards and signs on everyone?
Yeah, on the party. Yeah.
Okay.
Let's see here. Yeah. Only one Yantra, because this is something I was like, oh, wait a second, I should do this real fast, like.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Your roll here.
Yeah.
As well.
Although I suppose it's obvious when I cast a spell, isn't it?
If you're using an implement, yeah.
Yeah. Like, I think heartbeats, doesn't it? Yeah.
Or not obvious, but it can be.
Yeah.
Observed.
Right. Well, yeah. Right.
Especially with your...
Yeah. Especially with my freaking beacon of the... Yeah. Yeah. I got one success.
Okay. So fast, at what potency?
Six.
Ooh, all right. So you kind of like flick the little bar magnet across your palm, and there's kind of like a slight disturbance of like the gravel around you as it becomes slightly magnetic for a second.
Yeah.
And as your spell takes hold.
Mm-hmm.
And the guy kind of like shifts a step back slightly as his hulking companion sort of takes a step forward.
So that thing is like a solid shade.
Why don't you give me an intelligence and a cultural?
See. No successes. I don't know what anything is. Where am I?
I will tell you that whatever that is, it is a product of Death Arcana.
Okay.
I, Right. So, as all that happens, as us mages are, like, sizing each other up, I guess. Oh, shoot. I actually have that spell up. I can size him up. What the heck? All right. Well, as I'm sizing...